Hey everyone, RG here and welcome back to a brand new Sims 4 Speedbuild on the channel. Hope you're all doing amazing, and today you are joining me for a spring break! Woohoo! not really, but you do joining me for a vacation that your Sims can go over and enjoy some great time in this caravans, RV, camping site that I created for you in the past week. Now, before we even start, you can see that I'm placing those boxes, you can call them, or RVs and caravans to be on the lot, just trying to figure where they're gonna be, how the landscaping is gonna work. I did start with 7 of them, and at some point I decided that I want to create 4, and there's a good and really awesome reason for that, because you know me, every time I'm creating something, I'm trying to create that lot to be with more than one functionality, so you can play it in more than one way. It's not gonna be only rental, it's not gonna be only residential, it's not gonna be only a park. You can play it more than one way. I do try two ways, and sometimes even more, but this time you will be able to play this as two things. It can be a rental for a vacation that it is, in my opinion, it's a great place to go with your family for a vacation. And the other way to play it, it's gonna be a tiny living. So you're gonna have 4 RVs, or more like two caravans and 2 RVs, and each one of them is different. They're not gonna be the same. Each one of those caravans and the basically those mobile homes, each one of them is gonna look different. Each one is gonna be on his own uniqueness, you can call it. One is gonna be for one of them, if you're gonna ask me, is gonna be like for the old sim that retired and decided to go on a trip around the world, and he decided to take his own old, rusty, broken down RV with him, and at some point he decided to just stay here because, well, his RV broke down, and you're gonna see some tools on the ground and some really, really awesome things. So you really want to stick around and see what I did here, while some other RVs, one of them is really, really fancy, one of them is more like futuristic in the design of it, not really futuristic, but compared to the others it looks a bit more fancy. And there is another small one that is not completely broken, but a bit more like neglected, something like that. No one really invests in that mobile home. And there is one that is more for like a couple. And a nice story about this, the one for the couples, that it's a bit more modern style. But I did notice that you can actually place a double bed on a 3-tile-wide room, yet sometimes the Sims do go to the other side, like it will get into the bed on the side that is open, and then he will like slide to the other side, but sometimes it just doesn't work. So yeah, you are gonna have one of the RVs with a double bed that is a bit trickier for a gameplay, but you can always just switch that to a bunk bed now that we have them. And I do hope that they will fix that problem with the double bed, because it is really, really awesome that you can, well, I can do that in real life, so there's no good reason why not to be able to get inside the bed from one side and then just move to the other side, you know what I mean? And I really hope that they will fix that and they will add that into the game, so that RV will be more playable, or 100% time? 100% time, yeah, exactly, that's the term, RG. 100% of the time it will work and it will be much more easier to play in. Oh, and right now you can see me creating the wheels for the RVs, which is something really, really awesome. I think that you need to follow those instructions, or what I do over here, and you'll see how to do that yourself, because that is the way to actually create yourself a wheel with that cover on top of it, and create a real RVs, or if you want to create a bus or something like that, you can just mimic what I do over here and create your own one, of course using the amazing tool mod by Twisted Maxi. If you don't have that mod, you really need to get yourself the latest version. You can do that by checking it in the description down below. Now, before we even start talking about many things that I want to cover, including the new upcoming pack game pack that I'm super hyped for it. First of all, some information about this build. So this build, I originally built it in Willow Creek. So it like it's a map that all of you got in the game, and it's 50 by 50. Now, for those who follow me in the community tab in the past week, I actually showed you some teasers and I asked you what size of a lot you want it to be. And many of you asked for 50 by 50, and I said to myself that is exactly what I think is the best. So I went with it because, first of all of you got it in the game, and you don't need to delete some of my old builds or another build that you really like on a 64 by 64. Plus, I really thought that 64 by 64 for a big project like this, although it might look a bit more spacious, I don't think it will be the best suitable for it. And to be honest, I think that in this type of build, the location of it is more important than the size of it. And because I placed it on the 50 by 50 in Willow Creek, this is actually an amazing spot for this build. So I do not recommend for you to place it on another location, especially because if you notice at the beginning, I created that trail for the lot, and I kind of connected it with the existing like road outside of that lot. So it's kind of connected the best and perfect way. And I created even another area to go out from this camping site if you want to go for a nice stroll near this place in that location, you near the river, so you can go fishing, you can go hiking, you can go and enjoy some great time, jogging, do whatever you want. And it's really, really the best place, I think, for those caravans to stay in for an amazing rental vacation. So I highly recommend for you to place it exactly where I placed it. It's on the 50 by 50 lot in Willow Creek. Now you can of course go and place it in other places and see if it's fit more for you over there if you want it. But I highly recommend for you to place it in the original place where I built it. And right now you can see that I'm creating the front of the old RV, the broken down RV of course in my brain, of the old guy that is kind of left the RV over here, and he decided to live in the RV over here, and he's not gonna take it anywhere because it's kind of broke down already. And I just love that small fan that I placed over there. That's from the journey from Batu, and it's working. Basically, this is like the radiator cooling system of the van. So while you're playing the game, and you're of course in the play mode, that fan is gonna spin. So it's gonna really, really gonna look amazing, and we'll bring that build a bit more to life. So I really love that fan over there, and you can see that we're placing the lights on the front. Of course, we're gonna place the lights on the back of it. Also, I'm not quite sure if you're gonna see that on the like live on it, because this is actually a really long build. And in real life, I thought it's gonna be much like, I didn't thought it was gonna take that long for me to create it, but actually it was really, really long. If I'm gonna connect all the hours it took me, it was over 7 hours of building, just because of the small details. And you're gonna see I placed many small details, just like some weeds on the ground that are a bit going crazy because someone is not like chopping them down, and I placed many small objects that are just like the wrench that you're gonna see that I placed on the ground over here, and the bucket of water, and many, many other things just like that. And I even created the interior of that RV because I wanted it to almost feel like a real RV. So I created the two seats in the front with a shift that you can, well, kinda move the shift and play with the gears of the RV, and I created a wheel, and so I really invested a lot of time in the small details on this build, especially on this RV. I think that only that RV took 2 hours of working. Of course, I cut down a lot of the decisions process because it is taking time. And yeah, so I really hope that you're gonna enjoy this build and you're gonna like learn something from it, maybe how to create a bus or an RV yourself. And feel free, by the way, I see many people I really love to play some sort of like I see many people on Twitter love playing my stuff, and they are actually tagging me. So feel free to do that. It will be amazing to see what you do with my stuff. I do know that someone already tagged me on the zoo that I created like last week, and you just killed it. That was insane. That video went super viral, and I gotta tell you that it was so nice and amazing to see the love that you shared in the comment section. By the way, I do know that I haven't like respond to all the comments over there, and I do apologize for that. I really want to believe that you do know that. It's not that I'm like ignoring the comments that you are leaving. It just, it takes time to go all over the comments, but I do read them. It takes time to go and each one of you to give you a comment. And of course, you need to remember that I'm building. So just like this build, it took me 7 hours in the past week to do that. And of course, YouTube is not really a job for me. I'm not taking it as a job. So I do that with my time, and I do try to bring you more than one video sometimes a week. But when I do a project like this one, it's definitely not gonna be like with another video the same week. It's gonna be a project for a week. And so don't feel bad if you don't get a response from me when you're leaving a comment. I do read all of them. And but I will get to the comments on the zoo, and it was such amazing to see the support that you dropped over there, and thank you so much, because that video really blew my mind. It's already on 40,000 views, and it is such amazing to see the amazing the support and the love that you're spreading to me. And so thank you so much for that. And right now you can see that we are building the inside of the driver's seat, and the one that sit next to it. So, and you're gonna see me creating the wheel in a bit, and you can see that small bump, black bump over there, that's gonna be where the shift is gonna be. And I even placed some clocks, so it will give you the feel of, meters of the how fast you go, like the speedometer, right? Speedometer? How do you call that? So I created even that. And yeah, I definitely like spend a lot of time on, specifically on the broken down RV. I don't know why, but when you're creating something that is broke down or like post-apocalyptic or something like that, those things are taking so many time just because of the small deets that you are placing inside of them. You know what? This is actually very interesting for me. So let me know, after you see all the RVs and you're gonna see the inside of them and the outside of them and how all of them is gonna look, let me know in the comment section down below which one is your favorite in the style, design, the look. I really love this one, and I really love the more modern one that it's gonna be. I think it's the third one I'm gonna create over here, but this one really, really one of my favorites. And I created already a few vehicles in the game, and definitely this is one of my top five, I guess, vehicles that I created in the game. So yeah, let me know in the comment section down below which of the caravans or the RVs is your favorite. Now, if you are worried about the gameplay of it, do not be, because you know me already. I'm not like releasing for you things that you can't play with. I don't see the point of it. You can create something amazing, but if you cannot play with it or things are not functional, what's the point of that, right? So you can be sure that anything is working. It's actually a good moment in the video right now to tell you that you do not need to worry, because as you can see right now, I'm creating a restroom that is only one tile by two tiles, and I'm gonna fill inside a sink, a toilet, and a shower. And it will be like, for you, you're gonna say, wait a minute, those things are not gonna work together, right? Because the shower is over the sink, and how it's gonna work? You would be surprised. Anything is working in that RV, anything. And I play tested it, and I made sure that that it's gonna work. Now, one thing that is very, very important for you is to activate move object cheat code when you're placing any of my builds. This is some sort of like a metal rule over here, something really, really strong that you need to remember and do every time. Any of my builds, you need to activate the BB point move object cheat code, otherwise you're gonna like have missing places or stuff like that, because the game does not know to bring into the game builds that are involving objects that are interfacing one another. So you need to use that cheat code to make sure that the game know how to read the build, and then he will be able to bring it into the game the best way, or basically the way you see it in my build. So make sure to do that. Otherwise, you will end up, for an example, with that 1x2 restroom that do not have the shower or do not have the sink. So this is very important, make sure to do that, and everything in this build is working, functional, and you can do whatever you want. And that actually leads me to the upcoming pack. New game pack is coming, people, and I bet that you already know that. And if you do not know that, so many D's. Anywho, on the 1st on June, which is like what? 4 days from now, 3 days from now, we're gonna get a new game pack that is basically, they could call him RG's pack. They could call him RG's pack. RG Designer Pack or something like that, because they're gonna bring us the Decorator career into the game, which is one of my all-time favorite career in the game. In The Sims 3, it was just amazing to be an architect. And by the way, you know what? I think it's a really nice and good point for me to tell you that I'm actually thinking about changing the name of the channel. And I want to call the channel, because I'm doing like builds and I'm RG, I'm thinking about Architect. So let me know your thoughts about that idea, and probably it's gonna happen. But yeah, so the fact that they are bringing into the game the decorator career, and I saw the streams and I saw the teasers, and it was such fun to see the all amazing things that are gonna come. And I tweeted, of course, the stovetop, the separated unit that is a stovetop, and there is two versions of it. There is one that is basically on gas, and there is another one that is an electronic one, which is so neat and it looks so amazing and modern. It's gonna be so fun. And that little toaster oven that they brought into the game, that basically, I don't know if it's gonna like replace the microwave or something like that, but it looks awesome. And of course the modular object, the sofas, that you can do so many things with that, and the so many closets that you can combine together and move them, and those niches that you can create. You definitely can expect me to get that pack the moment it will drop off, and I'm gonna get it. I'm actually thinking about a new series regarding this pack in the channel, so you definitely want to stick around. Of course, it's gonna be related to building, but I do think about a new series in the channel with that pack. And to be honest, if I'm like completely honest with you, I am a bit disappointed that this pack did not drop like 1 week ago or something like that, because I could actually implement it the best way into this build. This build, those RVs and caravans could actually take so many things from that pack into them, because of the modularity that you have in that pack, if that's a word, modularity, I think it's a word, and if not, you know what I mean, like the modular objects that you can create your own objects. And I really recommend for you, once you are gonna get that pack, to add things to that build, to those RVs. Try to see if you can bring those stovetop. They can be much better, of course, in my opinion, than those one units of the oven with the stovetop in those builds in the current stage of them. So yeah, and I'm super curious to hear from you. What is the top thing that you saw in the upcoming pack? Is it the gameplay of being the decorator? Is it the objects? I don't know. Let me know what is your favorite thing that is gonna come with the new pack. I do know that many people are really hyped for the stovetop, but maybe you are like liking something else, and share that in the comment section down below. Now, again, you're gonna see right now we are at the like some sort of a bluish, light bluish RV, a bit more modernized than the old one. And in this one, you're gonna see me creating one by one like bathroom or restroom with a shower. Now, there is another like outdoor showering outside, like near it, because I was not sure that this is actually gonna work. But after testing it, yes, it's 100% like working, and the sink is actually near it. So you have all the three things, one near each other, so and they all working. And yes, you can see that I kinda block the entrance with that curtain. Don't worry, sinks can go through them. And that's, yeah, I was surprised also. And fully functional. Again, remember, I'm not releasing stuff that are not usable for you. And yeah, in this caravan, actually, in this RV, you're gonna have the double bed that I told you that sometimes it does work, the seams do slide to the other side, and sometimes it doesn't. So I think that we need to somehow make, I don't like the word force because it sounds bad, but we need to encourage, let's call it, that's a more nice way to say that, encourage the Sims team to fix that thing, because I do know that up until the moment we got, I believe, I want to say, so don't catch me on my word, but I want to say Dine Out game pack, right? I think that after that game pack, the ability of the Sims to go on into a bed that is pushed against a wall and then slide to the side that is like leaning the wall, that was a possibility for the Sims. And I do not know if it's like just broke down, like that gaming pack, that Dino, which is one of my favorite, kind of broke that thing, or they fixed it, because I don't think that needed a fix, because it was actually very, very convenient for us to place a double bed near the wall, so Sims can put a double bed on a three-widened wall or something like that. You know what I'm trying to say. So you don't need to have a full-size wall from both sides for the Sims to interact with the bed. Now I do know that now it's kind of still working, but not 100% of the time. Sometimes the Sims will slide to the other side. I don't know. I caught it like one time off camera with my eyes, basically. And then I tried to kind of caught it again, like catch it again with like on camera. So I'll have something to publish on Twitter and maybe to start things up. And people will join and say that, yes, they want the fix for that. But I didn't manage to do that. Every time the Sims did not slide to the other side. Anywho, I'm super hyped for the upcoming pack, and I hope that you are also. And that's what I wanted to talk with you. Do not go anywhere, because I'm gonna bring you some nice music to listen to while the building is continue. And of course, you still have two more RVs and caravans to watch. And I hope you're gonna enjoy the rest of the video, enjoy the tour at the end. And this is the moment for me to ask you nicely to hit the like button if you enjoy your time here with me. Subscribe to the channel if you are new here. And until the next time, keep that Sims party going for me, because Arjora Gaming, signing off. Oh girl, nah nah. Baby girl, don't need to flex. Dance to the rhythm and you do all the rest. Oh girl. When we are together, I surrender. Give you all my money, make you look so lovely, never feeling lonely. Baby girl, you're so fine, I can't get you off my mind. Ooh girl, nah nah. Ooh girl, nah nah. Baby girl, don't need to flex. Dance to the rhythm and you do all the rest. Ooh girl. Find myself guessing. Feel the beat tonight. Something good inside. Set you free. Let you lose all track of time. Come on, come on. Have a conversation. Don't treat me like a stranger. You give me motivation. Make my life vacation. When we are together, I surrender. Give you all my money. Make you look so lovely. Never feeling lonely. Baby girl, you're so fine.
Give it some time. By the end of our talk,